Can you imagine an island created not from concrete or bricks, but rather from materials like rock and sand? Do you think that this is possible? Well, believe it or not, this is exactly what Dubai has to offer. But how did they manage to do it? Let's find out. Hello and welcome back. In today's video, we're going to be talking about how Dubai made its artificial islands. Dubai is known for its luxury, ultra-modern architectures and opulence. Among the many firsts that the city has achieved, it has also made history by creating an island made from rock and sand. So what do you think about these artificial islands we made and what's so unique about them? We are here to tell you all about this and more. So, have you heard of the term land reclamation? Well, that's precisely what they did in this case. The massive archipelagos were created as a large land reclamation project. Millions of cubic meters of sand are dredged from the coastal regions of Dubai and dumped into specific formations to form the islands. The massive amounts of sand required to build the islands were acquired from the deep sea bed situated 6 nautical miles from the coast. For the construction of the artificial islands, large amounts of rock were moved from multiple quarries throughout Dubai. Now, this may sound easy and simple, but let us break it down for you. First, loads of sand had to be dug up from the Persian and Arabian Gulf floor. It later had to be vibro-compacted. If you're wondering what that is, vibro-compaction is a technique used to stabilize granular soils like loose sand and gravel so that the area becomes stable and dense. So once you have the mounds of sand in place, they had to be shipped with the help of GPS technology and then be surrounded by millions of rocks for added protection. So why do you think these islands were built in the first place? Well, the floating population of tourists in Dubai runs in the millions, and to accommodate and host all of them, it was necessary to boost their real estate. And come to think of it, what better than prepping a coastal real estate, right? Well, it all began in 2001. The crescent-shaped breakwater section of what came to be known as the Palm was the first to be constructed. While we earlier mentioned rocks lining the islands, there is more to it than meets the eye. There is geotextile membrane that prevents the sand from being washed away. This is further topped with at least 1 ton of rocks and 2 more layers of stones that weigh a minimum of 6 tons each. This ensures the inner island would be shielded from the strong sea currents and the seasonal shamal winds that blow in from Iraq. Now, this is no small project. The island covers an area that can be compared to 600 football fields, and it's 4 times as big as London's Hyde Park. A 100-meter wide opening is added to both sides of the crescent, which allows water to circulate and prevents it from being static. Another provision of a 6-meter wide boardwalk stretches all through the length of the crescent, and needless to say, this makes for a great spot to view the sunset. While the island would look splendid when viewed from above, a lot is happening below. A 6-lane sea tunnel was built using 200,000 cubic meters of reinforced concrete, 30,000 tons of reinforcing steel, and 11,000 tons of rock. The sole purpose of this was to connect the trunk of the crescent, which lies 25 meters below sea level. Building the tunnel was another challenge in itself. 2 1.2-kilometer-long dikes had to be constructed to form a dam to ensure the tunnel could be built under dry conditions. When we say dry conditions, we're talking about more than 5.5 million cubic meters of seawater being pumped out in a short span of 45 days. The dikes were later used as temporary roads for construction vehicles. Construction workers lived on the fronds, and it anchored cruise ships while building the island. And this wasn't all. All 2,000 fish were caught and relocated elsewhere to prevent them from getting trapped inside the drained space. 6 years later, the first residents of the $12 billion island moved in. Today, the 17 fronds are home to around 1,500 beachfront mansions with 6,000 apartments on the trunk. Significant hotels on the crescent include Atlantis, the Palm, and the Waldorf Astoria, with brands such as Fairmont and Viceroy on the trunk. Resorts in the works include the Royal Atlantis, next to the existing Atlantis Resort, and Palm 360, a 2-tower resort connected by a 155-meter-long sky pool. Did you know, before Donald Trump wanted to become the President of the United States, he was planning to build a 60-story hotel on the Palm? However, he wasn't successful due to the 2009 global financial crisis. In 2012, Nakheel, the property developer, opened the Al-Ittihad Park on the proposed site of the Trump project. Meanwhile, the underwater-themed Atlantis, the Palm, remains the flagship resort. It boasts a sprawling water park and more than 1,500 rooms, including the Royal Bridge Suite, that will set you back a cool $25,000 per night. But Dubai was not done yet. They wanted more islands. Work on an even more oversized island called Palm Jumeirah began in 2002, but soon fell flat when the 2008 financial crisis began. Land reclamation is completed, but no further development has been planned yet. Instead, Nakheel has opted for a scaled-back four-island project called Palm Jumeirah, launched in 2004 and is set to be 8 times larger than Palm Jumeirah. The 1,530-hectare development will eventually include hotels, residential towers, a sprawling mall, and a marina. A 6-lane sub-sea tunnel connects Palm Jumeirah to the mainland to facilitate tourism and make life easier for residents. A monorail that runs the length of the Palm opened in 2009 and is the only public transportation option on the island. The Palm Jumeirah has found success with people who desire luxury and leisure. Even as we speak, new resorts are still coming up on the Palm Jumeirah. Developers are persistently financing and building luxury apartments. The latest observation deck opened in 2021 on the 52nd floor of the Palm Tower, allowing you to see the entire island from the bird's eye. So is Dubai done with its islands? Despite the failure of a few other islands on the Dubai coastline, it appears that the booming city is not done yet. If you enjoyed our video, don't forget to check out the next video on why Dubai's artificial islands are abandoned. Before you do that, make sure you like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Hit that bell icon never to miss an upload, and we'll see you on the next video.